So iOS 11 introduced the feature emoji. This allowed you to use a little character. It looked at your face and it mapped your facial expressions to that character, and then you could send somebody a text message with a little recording with this. Now this only worked on the iPhone 10. Now in iOS 12 there's a few new emoji, and it works on more phones because all the new iPhone 10 phones, the 10S, the 10R, and the 10S Max also allow you to use emoji. But there's an even better feature. You can create your own emoji, a Memoji, and it's pretty easy to do. So here I am on an iPhone 10 and I'm going to go into messages, and when I want to send one of these emoji or Memoji messages, all I need to do is tap the button at the bottom that it looks like a little monkey face there, and it will bring me into the section where I can do this. Now I can flip through and choose one of the many emoji characters here, and you can see even as I'm choosing them it's looking at my face and it's mapping my facial expressions to what it's showing. But you can see here is one that kind of looks a little bit like me. This is a Memoji, and when I create it, creating a Memoji is a matter of going to the plus button here. You tap it and it goes into this interface where you create your own. So first thing you want to do is you maybe choose a skin color, and you can then choose freckles down here. You can adjust the skin tone a little bit. You can flip over to hairstyle and you can see all these different hairstyles here. So just flip through one. Now you don't have to make it look like you. You can go and make it look like anything that you want. So you can have fun with it as well. So you can go and choose the age. You could choose the kind of the chin type. Then you could play with the eyes, eyebrows. I'm just picking some at random here. And notice you could do things. You can choose, and then you can also change colors of things. Like there's the colors of the lips, different shades. Play with the ears. You can add earrings. You can add facial hair, eyewear, headwear like hats and such. And you can hit done. And now you've got a new Memoji. And you can see I've got that one and I've got this one. And once you've created it, now you can hit record and record something up to 30 seconds and then hit stop. And then you can hit the arrow button there and to send this as a message. And just like with emoji, it works of course with other people that also have iPhone 10s, but it will send as a little video for anybody else. So you can actually send this to anybody. They won't be able to send one back to you, but you know, you could at least send these and have fun with them. Now there's more that you can do with this. Let's see, we've got the three dots button down here, and you can see I can edit the Memoji I've got set there, or duplicate it and then edit the duplicate, right? And I can also delete it. So you can use Memoji and emoji in FaceTime. So here I am on my iPhone and I'm talking to my iPad over here signed into a different account. So what I can do is I can just tap in the middle of the screen and it brings up controls at the bottom. And I hit the control on the left and it brings up all these extra things I can do. So a lot of the stuff that you could do in Messages before, like little drawings and things like that, and even third-party apps, can now be put into FaceTime. But I'm going to just use the Memoji emoji one. And what I can do is I can choose one of the, you know, either the emoji or the one I made myself, or the one I made myself right here, and choose that one. I'm going to close that at the bottom and close those controls, and you can see now I'm actually talking using the emoji head instead of my head. And it still shows the background behind me. So this can be kind of fun, kind of a little extra bit of fun that you can have using FaceTime. And it's an extra place where you can use the emoji and Memoji besides just sending these brief little videos in Messages.